We have just hit the 1000 subscriber milestone. A big thank you to all of you. Having reached this milestone, this might be a good time to take a step back from the program and reflect on the overall learning strategy. So here are 8 strategies or mindsets that you can adopt to help you along your Fusion 360 learning journey. Many of these are lessons that I have learned from my own journey. Do stay tuned to the end where I have put together a recommended learning roadmap. Learning Fusion 360 is not about learning shortcuts or tricks. Granted, there are many repetitive actions in the program where adopting a shortcut can really save you a lot of time in the long run. For example, pressing E for extrude or pressing S to bring up the shortcut toolbar. Beginners especially tend to gravitate towards learning these shortcuts. It doesn't help that there is a huge pool of videos on YouTube that promote these shortcuts. In my own learning journey, I have never consciously looked for shortcuts to learn. These were just picked up along the way while I was learning other more important stuff. You really should focus more on learning the major commands and modeling techniques. Learning about these will save you much more time in the long run compared to shortcuts. What then should we focus on when it comes to learning Fusion 360? It goes without saying that you should dedicate a big chunk of your time to learning how to use the different commands. But perhaps more important than that is the learning of meta skills. By meta skills, I mean higher order concepts that allow you to master the program from a bird's eye view. Notable examples are multi-body modeling, contextual editing, the master model approach, and the surface patchwork approach. These are harder to learn compared to the actual nuts and bolts of using the program, but are also the most valuable skills in the long run. Moreover, these are concepts that are transferable to other CAD programs. Don't sweat the dimensions. Don't get me wrong. In the course of our designs, we should always make sure to fully define our sketches. That is one of the non-negotiable tenets of CAD modeling. However, when it comes to practicing, the focus should never be on fully defining sketches. I would go as far as to say that the effort spent in defining sketches actually impedes the learning process. Unless, of course, you are learning about how to define sketches in the first place. If half the time of a tutorial video is spent on defining dimensions, that is not time well spent. In most of my tutorials, I focus on the command or technique in question. You do not have to follow every single dimension on screen. In most cases, just a sketch that roughly follows what you see on screen will be sufficient for you to learn the technique in question. Remember, the most important thing is to understand the concept. Reduce barriers to practice. We are all guilty of just mindlessly consuming YouTube videos and not practicing. Watching a video 10 times does not yield the same benefit as practicing once inside of Fusion 360. Often, we will come up with a host of excuses for not practicing. I don't have access to the file or drawing mentioned in the video. The overall model is too complicated. I don't have time to go through every single detail to create that. I myself have faced this numerous times in the past. We need to shift our mindset and gradually chip away at these perceived barriers. You do not need to refer to the final drawing or file of the finished model. Oftentimes, it is possible to create an approximation of what you see on screen to learn about the technique being shown. There's no reason to go through the whole video in one sitting. Break the video into small chunks and practice a small snippet of the video at a time. Use tutorials wisely. It is often a struggle to find YouTube videos to learn something new about Fusion 360. This is especially the case for intermediate users. There are a ton of tutorials out there that showcase pretty complex looking models. But more often than not, these are simple extrudes based on complicated sketches. When you come across a new video, I would recommend that you watch at 2x the speed for the first time or scrub through the entire timeline. This will allow you to get an idea of what new concepts or techniques that you can hope to learn. Don't spend time in what you already know. Nothing that is worth learning comes without a struggle. Always be willing to try modeling something that seems slightly out of your depth. In my own personal experience, I learn the most when I struggle the most. Even if your attempt is only an approximation, you will find the process worthwhile. Every time you stretch that modeling muscle, it becomes a little bit stronger. Over time, models that used to faze you will become less and less of a challenge. Try a 365-day learning project. This is where you try to pick up something new every day about the program. The main challenge here is to find that something new. This will obviously be easier for beginners. For intermediate users, you might have to go through 4-5 videos to learn about something new. In this case, you probably cannot afford to be too selective about what you consider to be new. Once you find it, don't just note it down. Open the program and practice the new thing that you have just learned. If this is too challenging, you can adjust this to every other day or every week. Here is where we take a leaf out of a photographer's book. Photographers often practice the art of seeing or framing without their cameras when they are just walking about the streets. As designers or engineers, we can do the same by looking at the objects around you and thinking about how to model them inside of Fusion 360. For me personally, I am often drawn to cars and consumer electronics. I would often take a picture of what I see and try to create the object in Fusion 360. If creating the whole object is too daunting, you can isolate a certain feature and try that. As a wrap to this video, I'm going to go through a recommended learning roadmap for all Fusion 360 users. You can use this as a guide to plan your learning journey. As a beginner, your first port of call would be the extrude command. Here, you will learn how to create closed profiles and use them to do simple extrudes. From here, users would often jump to learning other commands. This is a mistake. Knowing what I know now, I would have put far more energy into learning about the intricacies of the extrude command. It is by far the most essential and flexible tool in the whole program. It is capable of creating more complex shapes than most users think. So once you have learned the basics, don't stop there. Continue to deep dive into the extrude command. At this point, it would also be good to spend some time to learn about the shell and fillet commands. However, the priority should still be on mastering the extrude command. After you have a pretty good handle of the extrude command, I would recommend that you learn your first meta skill, which is multi-body modeling. This is where you perform extrudes of different bodies and perform Boolean operations based on the way bodies interact with each other. You should focus on the combine and split body commands here. The multi-body modeling approach requires a mindset shift and can often be counterintuitive for beginners. It is an essential skill in learning how to create complex shapes that cannot be performed with simple extrudes. On the side, if you have time, also learn about the offset face command. Next, you should graduate to the second tab where you learn how to use surfaces. There is no need to deep dive into the surface commands yet. At this point, just learn how to do a simple extruded surface. More importantly, learn about how to use surfaces in conjunction with solid bodies. If you have time, try to learn about creating a patch surface. With knowledge in multi-body modeling and the basics of surfacing, I would encourage you to next learn about the mother of all meta skills, the master model approach. This is a top-down design approach where you create a master model and partition it into various components. Next, I will go back into the surface tab to learn more about the various commands. Specifically, at this point, you should try your hand at creating solids by building a patchwork of surfaces and stitching. Obviously, there are many other commands in Fusion 360 not mentioned here. Most of these other commands are aids more than necessity. For these, you can learn them at your own time. Lastly, allow me a little bit of self-indulgence in talking about the 1000 subscriber milestone. I started this channel without much expectation at all. It has been a gratifying experience to be able to gain an audience of this size. A special thank you to my patrons on Patreon and many others who have bought me coffees along the way. If you would like to support me on Patreon or buy me a coffee, the links are provided below. Also, feel free to provide suggestions on how we can improve moving forward.